So the Republican convention, as everybody knows, is going to take place 4 days after Donald Trump's criminal sentencing on July 11th. And apparently the folks at the RNC aren't exactly super confident that their nominee is not going to be in jail by the time that convention rolls around. So RNC chair Michael Watley had to head up to Milwaukee to work out the logistics of what they could do if their nominee is sitting in a jail cell during the convention. Here is what Michael Watley told Newsmax when they asked him, you know, hey, you know, what if he's jailed? He says, yeah, we're working on that right now. I'm actually going up to Milwaukee this week and we're going to have a series of conversations, not just one conversation, but a series of them. Because apparently it's a big deal, but he continued. We accept that Donald Trump is going to be in Milwaukee and he's going to be able to accept that nomination. And if not, we'll make whatever contingency planning we need to make for it. But the fact is, he's going to be our nominee and he's going to be the 47th president of the United States. You know, we'll cross that bridge, but you sort of have to go into this stuff as we certainly will be planning on it. We'll be thinking about it and we're working on that right now. But what we want to do is we want to have a show that is going to roll out Donald Trump and his vision for America, which is going to set up this election cycle. And we may have to do it via Zoom again because, you know, he could be in jail. So first of all, let's lay out a couple possibilities here. It's not necessarily that Donald Trump could be in jail. He could be under house arrest, in which case, why not just move the convention to Mar-a-Lago, right? I mean, that's where he'll be. Just do it there. There's plenty of space. He would love the money anyway. That would make him happy. But even if Trump gets sentenced to house arrest or jail, typically the sentence does not begin immediately, like right at that moment. Like Donald Trump is not going to leave that courthouse, even if he gets jail time, which is, you know, very unlikely. But even if he does, he's not going to leave the courthouse in jail. The judge will say, here is your sentence, and your sentence begins on this date. So Trump will not be under house arrest and he will not be in jail when that convention rolls around. That's just not going to happen. And if it does, you know, that's probably not a good thing, would leave it open for a very easy appeal. So that's the realistic possibility there. But I also want to point out something here. There's a reason why Donald Trump installed his two cronies, Michael Watley and his daughter-in-law, Laura Trump, as the head of the RNC. Because any normal person running the Republican Party right now would not be saying, hey, I got to go to Wisconsin and try to work out the logistics if my guy's in jail. A normal person wouldn't do that. A normal person would be saying, hey, I'm going to go to Wisconsin and work out the logistics on how we're going to nominate somebody else that's not going to face the possibility of jail, right? Because that's the obvious solution. Like, oh no, our nominee's in jail. Wonderful. Pick somebody else. You already know, by the way, that Nikki Haley polls way ahead of President Biden in head-to-head hypothetical matchups. She was the runner-up of the primary. You've got your candidate right there if you were smart and you wanted to do that. But the RNC passed a rule a couple years ago saying that you can only vote for the person who received the most votes in your state. So any vote for Nikki Haley at that convention is automatically thrown out and not counted according to their own rules. Again, if Trump's cronies weren't running the RNC, they would go ahead and scrap that rule and leave it wide open. But this is why Trump wanted to take over the Republican Party. He succeeded in that. And now they got to prepare for what happens if he's in jail for their convention.